Saman Soleymani, physician, owner of Avecina Medical, and I am the Grip.org episode number 7 guest coming up in July 2022. Welcome to my garage with some of my cars as part of my addiction that I have. Not all the cars are here. Some of the cars are out for service, but we can definitely discuss some of these cars as time allows. So it's pretty well known within my friends and acquaintances that I'm a huge Lamborghini person, and I'm not sure what drew me to the Lamborghini brand, but it did not start in adulthood or after success. As early as probably 6 or 7 years old, I just fell in love with Lamborghini. And you know, this is around the time when the Countach was out. I think every kid had a poster of a Countach under the San Francisco Golden Gate Bridge, and I definitely did have one of those. Lamborghini finished out the Murcielago series with the Murcielago 670 Super Veloce. There's only 44 of these that ever came to the United States, so they're a very special car. It's a V12 naturally aspirated all-wheel drive, and it is currently one of the most coveted Lamborghinis because they're just so rare. Many of them have been totaled throughout the years, and it's a very, very special car. They only made 186 for the entire world, 44 of them that came to the United States, and this is a great example of what. To continue, we'll skip the Pagani for now. This is one of the latest Lamborghini acquisitions. You know, after the Murcielago series ended, Lamborghini started with the Aventador in 2012. But I'm, again, usually the type that I don't like the initial releases. I like to wait until the end of the run and get the most limited and most special version. So Lamborghini, to, you know, end the Aventador series, they came with the SVJ, which is an amazing car, which is, you know, had the Nürburgring record. Beat the Porsche GT2 RS around the Nürburgring. And then they made a further specialized version called the 63 Roadster, and it was to celebrate Lamborghini's 63rd anniversary. And it has very special, they only made 63 of these for the world, with less than 20, I think like 20 of them that came to the United States in a Roadster version. And it has very unique features. These are not stickers, these are all painted underneath the clear coat. Lots of carbon fiber everywhere. You can see this has been further customized with my son's child seat, because he always negotiates and wants me to take him for a drive. You can see a roof snorkel that was custom designed for this car. Everything was custom from Lamborghini. We spent quite a bit of time, literally every stitch, every paint, everything that you see was designed by me with Lamborghini. So this is a great car. It's an open top. It's a hard top, open top, and the two carbon fiber panels fit in the bonnet up front. So this kind of completes literally 30 years of Lamborghini, from the Diablo series, Murcielago series, and the Aventador series. And it goes without saying that, you know, probably arguably the most beautiful design hypercar in the world is a Pagani. And I remember first time even hearing the word was on Top Gear a couple of decades ago with the Zonda. And I was I was blessed enough to be able to acquire this Pagani Huayra last year. And they only made 99 coupes for the entire world, with less than 30 of them that came to the United States. What makes the coupes very special, the Pagani coupe, is one, their doors are what we call gullwing, and it is the only gullwing Pagani that's ever been made. So instead of Lamborghini, which has the doors, in a sense, kind of like a butterfly or scissor doors where the hinge is down here, Pagani has made the gullwing, which really makes this car extremely dramatic. Every Pagani is a one-off car, but this car had very, very special, unique things, customization through Pagani. Obviously, there are no aftermarkets for this car, but lots of carbon fiber. It's a combination of pearl white, two different color carbons. If you notice that some of the carbons are a silver gray titanium and some are black, and they alternate back and forth. All the interior, most Paganis that you'll see, all the interior metal pieces are in polished aluminum. Only their track cars are done in black anodized. And if you look, every single metal piece that you're here was black anodized, customized from Pagani to be black anodized. After I received the car, I decided to do further customization on the car, and Pagani has what they call a Tempesta package. And the Tempesta package combines 10, has 10 different things that are changed on the car. So all four wheels and tires are changed to lighter wheels, larger setup. The front bumper diffuser is changed, the rear diffuser is changed. All suspensions are changed to Olin's four-way adjustable suspensions. The entire underside of the body is changed. And also, you also get a newer, lighter, higher flowing titanium exhaust. And then we definitely could not stop there. And this car originally did not come with a roof smoke hole or the wing that is on their track cars. And discussing my vision with the Pagani family, we were able to have them install the snorkel, install the what they call the big wing, and really kind of completes the car. And so this is truly one of the most beautiful cars I've ever seen or driven, not being biased. And after owning it for a year, it's probably the only car that to this day when I get in it, I still can't believe it's mine. And I kind of giggle like someone let me borrow it for a day. It's that special. So I'm glad to be able to share this with you guys. So thank you guys for joining us for a few minutes, allowing me to share some of my cars that are here today. Please make sure to watch the episode hitting July 1st, episode 7. Can't wait for the next time.